This video, I'll be making acetamide, which is a really strange organic compound to say the least.
Oh no!
I'll be mainly making it to turn it into methylamine, and you're probably like, hey man, did you do it before? Yeah, but the methylamine HCl in that video is heavily contaminated with some foreign salts, and I need it pure. So, to start off, I've weighed out around 70 grams of ammonium acetate. Then I've added it into a 100ml round bottom flask that was placed into a heating well. Then a little bit condenser was attached on top and it was filled with water. And I've cranked the heating mantle to the max. If you know how to chemistry, then you probably know we're going to be performing a reflux. As the temperature goes up, the ammonium acetate crystals eventually start to liquefy and they start breaking down. Once everything liquefies, I get absolutely butt-fucked by an extremely familiar yet irritating smell. Which means some of the ammonium acetate is breaking down into its components. The biggest problem with this is that our yield is being very harshly lowered. To prove the presence of ammonia, I've lowered the wet pH paper into the condenser. At first the pH paper starts turning green and then it turns purple, which means the water on the paper absorbed ammonia gas and it turned alkaline. At 160°C, the ammonium acetate should start breaking down into acetamide. Once the temperature was hit, the ammonia production slowed down and I could finally take off the gas mask and the goggles. In the flask there should be acetic acid, ammonium acetate and acetamide. So what's happening here is basically a dehydration reaction. Under heat, the ammonium acetate molecule gets dehydrated into acetamide, which results in a bunch of water refluxing in the condenser. However, that isn't why we are doing a reflux. The reflux is for trapping the ammonium acetate, which will eventually start boiling, because its boiling point is at around 120°C. But because we're using a reflux column, the ammonium acetate will crystallize on the walls. In fact, here's some crystallizing on the walls as I speak. But because water is present and because ammonium acetate is highly hygroscopic and soluble, it will eventually soften or even dissolve and go back straight into the reaction flask. You can see the water vapor condensing on the walls and I've eventually added some aluminum foil to thermally insulate the flask. Anyway, around 1.5 hours in, I've deemed the reaction to be mostly complete.
Hey you, yeah you, Prussian Blue is coming to Discord. You should join my Discord server now!
Anyway, I've set up a quick distillation apparatus and yes, this is a really bad thermometer head. I've planned for it to go into a three-way adapter only, but I guess I went a little bit too far. So I start up the heating. Once the temperature of the solution reaches around 130°C, a bunch of liquid starts condensing. This liquid is most likely ammonium acetate, water or even acetic acid. Once the temperature reaches 150°C, there seems to be nothing coming over. So I've decided to stop the heating and transfer the remaining solution into a beaker. Okay, so here I've pipetted a sample of the solution into a test tube and I was hitting it with a blowtorch. I wanted to see if there was any water in it and it seems like there was quite a bit of steam. And that gave me a tip that I should probably hit it a little more. As I was hitting it on a hot plate, I started to detect a strong vinegar smell and my eyes became irritated, which probably means that I didn't distill everything off. I don't know, it just really amazes me because I've did that distillation for like an hour. Eventually a white dense cloud started coming from the beaker and it stopped smelling like vinegar. So I've let it cool down and placed it into a fridge. Acetamide generally has a problem with crystallizing, so I've waited quite a long time. Anyway, eventually I was met by a really interesting sight, which is the acetamide crystals crystallizing from the top, and it was actually really cool to see. Okay, so if glacial acetic acid was still present, there was a good chance of some ammonium acid making it as well. So to see if you have any, I decided to smell that crystallized acetamide, and it had an extremely interesting smell. Wikipedia says that it has a mouse-like smell when it's impure, and well, judging from the color, it is quite impure, because pure acetamide is white. I've never really smelled a mouse, but I guess it kind of smells like you would imagine extremely dry and old Cheetos to smell, if that makes sense. That reassured me that we most likely have no ammonium acetate in the mix. Anyway, I've tried to break it up, but it was extremely hard, tough and girthy. Okay, maybe without the last part. And because of that, I've eventually had to bring out a literal chisel. Eventually the whole thing gave way and I weighed out everything out. So our yield is around 13 grams of brown acetamide. The theoretical yield of acetamide is 55 grams, which gives us a yield of a whopping 23%. Yay. Yeah, when I got it into a calculator, it made me want to cry. Anyway, I'll have to purify it either by distilling the acetamide or by recrystallization. But I'll do that off camera. Anyway, thanks for watching.